And so it was that David really wanted to bring the Ark of the Covenant to Judah. You see, because the Ark of the Covenant really represented the presence of God. And so David got a number of priests and Levites, and they took the Ark of the Covenant, you know, put it in a new cart and an oxen, and tried to bring it to Judah. On their way, it looked like the Ark of the Covenant was falling off. And so a man called Uzzah reached out, you know, to touch the Ark of the Covenant. And Bible says that God struck him dead. And because of that, David was afraid, and he was also annoyed, because he thought, how will I ever bring the Ark of the Covenant into Judah? And so they decided, let's just, you know, put the Ark of the Covenant into a house of a man called Obed-Edom, you know, as we think of how we will bring it to Judah. And Bible says the Ark of the Covenant remained in the house of Obed-Edom the Gittite, and he prospered so much that the whole of Israel knew. In fact, even David was told that Obed-Edom has prospered so much because of the Ark of Covenant being in his house. And so in a materialistic world like the one that we are living in, we oftentimes go to God because we just want his blessings. Now, God wants us to want him. God wants us to pray for his presence amongst us. God wants us to seek his kingdom. As the word of God says, seek the kingdom of God and all its righteousness, then all these things shall be added unto you. So it's not just seeking his hands, it's seeking his face. It's not just seeking his blessings, but seeking the blesser. For when you have the blesser, then the blessings will automatically come.